Alex works at a store that's been inside that perimeter for the last 8 days. He lives within a few miles of the search area. He's live with me. So, Alex, I'm not sure if you could hear the interview that I was just doing before you with John Muffler. He's a former U.S. Marshal, but he said they've now confirmed that some of those homes that are unoccupied, Cavalcante's been in there, disheveled areas, beds maybe, or couches, and scrape and break-in marks on the doors. This is your neighborhood. I can only imagine how that makes you feel.
It's news to me. I didn't know anything about that. We're just really going off of our local customer base and the customers that come into us and tell us about their experience and what they're going through. So that's kind of it's an update to, I guess, a lot of people that's happening, that he's found refuge in abandoned homes, or not abandoned homes, but vacation homes, and something that I've never been told about. So all I know is that our local customer base is the ones that can come into the store and can get to us are they're happy to be out, and they're happy to be in the community again and not stuck in their homes.
Alex, and one of the other things that John Muffler told us was that they've seen evidence now that the backpack that he found or took or stole or got somehow after he left prison, because he didn't have it at that jail, it's laden. It's full of supplies now, presumably from some of the homes that he's been in, according to this breaking news tonight. You've got kids, you and your wife. How are you, what are you doing at night? How are you keeping yourselves and your kids safe?
That's everybody's concern too. I mean, I don't live directly in the area that this search is going on, and I know that our local customer base has told me about a lot of things that they're experiencing. I'm confident in my family to protect ourselves, so I know that we're okay, but we always worry. You know, this guy's going south, and he could go into the area that I live, and everybody's locking their doors. They're becoming more aware of doors that they've never locked before in their lives, and getting, you know, security cameras, getting lights on outside. We've noticed a huge influx of keys that we're selling, locks, flashlights, anything to detect things that they weren't commonly used to. So. I know that makes sense. Yeah.
Can I jump in for a moment? I only have about 40 seconds left, but, you know, a lot of people I'm learning have shown up there as vigilantes looking for the $20,000 reward. Have you seen any evidence of that? And if so, are you happy about it? Or are you frustrated by it? How are you processing the vigilantes?
We've been very kind of happy about the police presence in the area and these new people that are coming in to help with the situation, whether they're vigilantes or they're other groups. We just don't know what they're about. We hope that they're going to be safe, that they're going to not cause any problems, but we don't know them. We're happy with the Pennsylvania State Police and what they're doing so far. They're protecting as well as they can, but these other people, we don't know what they're about and what their motives are.
Alex Pyle, thank you so much for taking the time tonight. I'm praying for you and all your neighbors that you're going to be okay and that this is going to be wrapped up. This is day 9. It's 9 days too many. So stay safe out there, you and your family, okay?
Great. Thank you.
Thank you for watching. Go to NewsNationNow.com to find News Nation on your television provider. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button below to get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.